This is it. My top 10 albums of 1976. Let's jump right in with a really unique entry at number 10. Penguin Cafe Orchestra, with music from the Penguin Cafe. It's almost indescribable, but I'll do my best. It's kind of a quirky chamber pop ensemble, avant-garde instrumental, folk, minimalist, maybe like Sufjan Stevens' forefathers or something. It's weird and it's cool and it's beautiful. This was their first album, and the second one wouldn't come for another 5 years. So pause this video, go listen to it immediately, and then come back when you're done. In the ninth spot is another groundbreaking live release, this time from Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band. All four sides of this double album blew me away. The music rocks so hard, and his voice is so perfectly made for this style of music. Their studio album, Night Moves, was also from this year and is excellent as well. Out of nowhere came an album that I loved so much I went out and bought it. Jimmy Bell's Still in Town by 156075, otherwise known as the Numbers Band. This is a live recording from a local Ohio band opening in Cleveland from Bob Marley and the Wailers. Musically, it has the energy of the Blues Brothers, but with a vocalist that half speaks, half sings in a free-form, beat poetry sort of delivery. Their riffs, their grooves, their tightness, even in the midst of experimentation that sounds like it might go off the rails at any second, it's all truly unprecedented. I'm so glad I found the right list that pointed me toward this album. Sadly, it was another 6 years, though, before they released a second album. Next up is John Anderson at number 7. His band Yes was on a bit of a hiatus, so he released a solo album called Elias of Sun Hillow. It's best described as ambient prog. A modern equivalent might be Sigur Rós. Like many prog releases, it's a concept album. I think it was about aliens or something. I played it over and over and over. I love it so much. After some high concept prog rock, everyone needs a little ABBA to cleanse the palate. At number 6 is Arrival, their magnum opus as far as I'm concerned. I already loved Dancing Queen and Knowing Me, Knowing You, which are both here, but a fun little song called I Kissed the Teacher was new to me, and now it's also one of my favorites. Kicking off the top 5 is Willie Nelson. As far as crossover gospel albums go, I'm only really familiar with those from Elvis Presley around these years, but Willie does just that with his album, The Troublemaker. The title track puts a very clever emphasis on Jesus' rebellious ways, but he mostly sticks to the classics here, like When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. As usual, he released several other albums this year. I could honestly listen to Willie sing the phone book, but I really love hearing him sing the hymn book. Boston is at number 4 with their self-titled debut. This is flawless pop rock. It starts off with two of the greatest rock songs of all time, More Than a Feeling and Peace of Mind. The slick, polished production is a sign of what was to come in hair metal, but this album did it first and did it best. My third favorite album of the year is another one I own, 1976's In Another Land by Larry Norman. If you don't follow Christian music, you may not be familiar with it, but it is a huge album for those of us that do. Larry Norman is essentially the man who put Christian rock on the map, and this album is one of his best. There's so many classics on here, heavier stuff like The Rock That Doesn't Roll, alongside more gentle ones like I Am a Servant and One Way. I've been listening to these songs all my life, and they continue to remain favorites. Only two remain. My runner-up is the debut album from The Ramones. This is a huge album in the rise of the punk rock movement. It opens with their signature song, Blitzkrieg Bop, which you may know as, Hey, ho, let's go, hey, ho, let's go. It's one of the greatest album one, track ones of all time as far as I'm concerned. Other highlights include Beat on the Brat and the slightly more gentle I Wanna Be Your Boyfriend. And finally, my favorite album of 1976 might be yours too, Songs in the Key of Life by Stevie Wonder. Nothing can come close to the scope and quality of this double album. Many consider it one of the greatest of all time. This was my first time through it, but there were plenty of songs I already knew, like I Wish, Isn't She Lovely, Sir Duke, Pastime Paradise is here, a song borrowed later by Coolio for his hit Gangster's Paradise, and Weird Al for Amish Paradise, of course. This album features a cornucopia of musical styles, but still remains a cohesive collection. And there's a pervading message of positivity, love, interracial harmony throughout all of these songs. Art is subjective, so while these are definitely my favorites, they may not be yours. So I'd love to hear from you about these and any others you liked from this year. Until then, I'll be viewing films and listening to music from 1977 and looking forward to telling you all about them. See you then. Thanks for watching.